So ever since I was a small boy, I've been interested in medicine. Probably it's from my father, who was also a family practitioner. And I think seeing how people value his work and how his work resulted in something that was really meaningful.
Even as a kindergartner, I mean, I would say the first thing that I wanted to be when I was a kid was a dinosaur. And it took me a couple years to realize that little boys don't grow up to be dinosaurs. And when that happened, just about the second thing I wanted to be was a doctor.
My parents were not medical people. Actually, I wasn't the first in my family to go to college, but it was sort of my generation. I was the first to go to college. My mother actually was forced to leave school when she was a kid by her father so she could work. And my father just had a high school diploma. So, not a medical family at all. Far from it.
I never really spoke to a physician who wasn't my pediatrician before. So I never really thought about it as a profession that I could have.
Basically, the human body is totally fascinating. It all boiled down to, I think I took an advanced biology class in high school where we did like dissections of sheep and, no, not sheep, I'm sorry, sharks, frogs, pigeons, and I just got really sucked in by the anatomy. It was totally beautiful, and I thought this physiology, this anatomy, this is something I got to learn more about. Plus, I come from a family where you really had to, you were expected to go to graduate school. I mean, undergraduate school was just like the start of things, and I hated law, and I hated business, and I really wasn't smart enough to get a PhD, so that really only left medicine.
I was always a smart, geeky kid, you know, so I guess, you know, great things are always expected of me from my family. I was definitely the nerdy one growing up. I was sort of, you know, give Rwanda a book, she'll be happy.
I was never an engineer. I was never a computer science person, but I really love science fiction. And finally, I was trying to figure out how in my career am I going to blend this love and interest for science fiction with medicine. Well, luckily came the robot in medicine.
I think from an early age, I understood that that helping people was something that I enjoyed doing and my parents encouraged me to do. And when I looked around at different, and even as a kid, you know, I looked around at different things that people did, I realized that medicine was one profession where you really get to help people while leveraging cool gadgets.
I think by the end of high school, I was intrigued by medicine. But my decision to become a doctor was probably made later, sometime like during college. And even then, like I really wanted to go to medical school because I was kind of interested in learning about medicine, but I never really thought of myself as someone who actually practiced medicine. And then when I got to medical school, I kind of got sucked into this actually could be a fun career.
I was very stereotypical. I went through the process. The road was laid out by guidance counselors, and you know, when I learned what it meant to be pre-med, and so I knew that I had to choose this step and that step and that step. And coming from a family that wasn't very educated, the attitude was you've just forged ahead. And so I never really considered, you know, taking time off. I went straight through. So I'm, you know, I kind of one of those boring, like, I went to college, I went to med school, I went to residency.
I had always thought about medicine, just thought it was interesting, thought it was cool, thought, you know, good to be able to fix people. My father was sick when I was in college. He had lung cancer, and I think that that's when I sort of started to weigh the severity of sort of the decisions of what I was going to do with in the future.
Yeah, my road was a little circuitous. I didn't go into medicine right away. I did an undergrad at UMass Amherst. I wanted to be a scientist, I thought. I was okay as a scientist. I wasn't great. And I think I was in graduate school finishing up a master's degree, and I actually had a I had an advisor say to me, "You ever think about going into medicine?" And at the time, I thought that was crazy because I didn't know any physicians and I didn't have any money. I didn't know how I would make it happen, and I was just looking forward to work. And it didn't make sense to me, but she had said something to me. She said, "I think your skill set would be much better suited for medicine than for bench science. So I think you're not utilizing some tools that you have here." And I filed that away. And then I worked for a couple of years, and I was lucky enough to work in a lab that worked with some docs. And I saw them doing research, and I saw these physicians. And that was the first time. I was probably about, maybe about 23, 24, where I was like, oh, maybe this is a great, maybe I could do this. This seems like a great profession. So that's when I first started medicine. I had already been in graduate school and undergrad and worked for a year or so before I even thought of medicine.
It's a great blend of science and art. And you feel good about yourself when you do something that people appreciate.
Yeah.